And good morning, everybody. Welcome back to Jet Radio 1400. Now, this is the half hour we spend with Sam Catania of Sam Catania Painting, and I don't know what to call the show because I understand from some subtle hints the man has dropped. We may be changing the name of the show, but I like this. I like the spontaneity. I'll be honest, Sam. I like that.
So, AC, it all started with, we started as Colorful Tips, and
right.
It was all set up to take in calls, help do-it-yourself homeowners.
Yeah.
Just so they don't make mistakes. And we quickly evolved into, which would have been Colorful Tips number 11 today, but because we quickly evolved, now we're like a pillar of the community and we're bringing in special guests.
Yeah.
So now today we are making a name change. So today's name change is Catania Chronicles, number 11, Catania Chronicles. And our first guest is my newest business partner, Corey Braden, Off-Road Tackle Box.
What's happening, everybody?
Yeah, hey, Corey. Thanks for coming in.
Absolutely.
You know, Sam always like takes like the last 45 seconds of the show and talks about Off-Road Tackle Box, so it'll be fun to talk about.
I just wish Corey heard that stuff.
Yeah. He's working. Corey is working. That's the kind of partner you want.
Is that what you call that?
We like to tend to think it's working, but yes, it is working.
So I'm just going to put it out there in the beginning. Just so you know. And, you know, AC, I can't sit still.
Yeah, I know you can't.
This is ridiculous.
I know. I know.
So, I'm going to put it out there in the beginning. Sam Catania Painting has evolved to make commercials butchering our last name because even through high school and middle school, people cannot pronounce Catania. They just butcher it. So, we said, why not play on that and use it for branding? Well, mm-hmm. Corey, I'm sorry, brother. You're in the same boat now.
Oh, no.
People have no idea what Off-Road Tackle Box mm-hmm. is.
That's true.
So I'm talking to my cousin on the phone who knew all about it. She rides by it all the time. We're talking about my truck. Yes, everybody, I still own that big blue monster truck.
That's right.
So my truck will be sitting there on Peach Street all the time. So this summer, if you see my truck, that's Off-Road Tackle Box. So her and I are talking, and I told her, I said, you gave me some great material today. I didn't tell you this, Corey.
No,
he was trying to get it out of
now.
Me. You gave me some great material. She said, oh, tomorrow you have a special guest again. Tomorrow. Oh, that's your business partner of, she was stuttering.
Yes.
what's the name of that place? Off-Road Shoebox. I said, you're joking, right?
Yeah.
She said, what? I said, she's like, Off-Road Shoebox. I said, I love it. You gave me material. This is material.
Off-Road Shoebox. Off-Road Shoebox.
Yeah, I don't know from a marketing standpoint if that would work.
Right.
I just don't think it would.
And
it would make it seem like a very small store, I can tell you that much.
That's why I said, Corey, join the crowd, dude. You're here.
Yeah.
You're here. You're going to continuously live with that.
It's when you're branding yourself, sometimes it's not the most simplest.
I'm sorry, but turn around. Oh, you missed it.
Oh, my God.
Turn around.
What is going on?
Oh, yeah.
Did you see it?
State Street's finest.
It's.
You were talking. Oh, hold on. He's
downtown fashion show.
I wish you could see this,
babe. We're soaking up the sunshine right now.
What is he doing?
I don't know, but he's representing for the Orioles, I'll tell you that much, in that hat. Okay. I should have brought a Blue Jays hat for my team, you know, just to compete with them.
Go on.
Basically, a lot of times, and a lot of people have asked, where is Off-Road Tackle Box coming from? Where did that name come from? And it's one of those that when you go off-roading, you a lot of times have a pack. You have a box.
Sure.
You have a kit. You have your recovery gear. You have your rope. You have your shackles. Mm-hmm. You have your D-rigs. You have all that stuff to go off-roading. And my brother's a huge fisherman. And he says to me, you know, why Off-Road Tackle Box? I says, well, you get to go fishing and you grab a tackle box. Why can't I grab a tackle box and go off-roading? And I'll be damned. That's pretty brilliant.
Yeah.
And so that's kind of where the Off-Road Tackle Box evolved from.
Well, yeah. And you're right, though, because if you know anything about off-roading, you gotta have your stuff
mm-hmm.
because the whole point is you can get yourself in situations where you need to sort of, you know, power your way out, figure your way out. That's the fun of it. Mm-hmm. If you wanted just a totally safe ride, you just take a ride on I-79, I suppose,
call it
at a reasonable rate of speed and say, well, this is no adventure, but I feel good. Yeah.
Right.
But the adventure is, and you've got to be prepared for any adventure, whatever you're doing.
Absolutely.
Hunting, fishing,
absolutely,
rock climbing, you've got to bring stuff.
And that's the one thing about the ropes that we're bringing to the market is not only for off-roading, but for everyday life. Whether or not your son, your daughter, or whoever it may be. I ended up having to rescue my girlfriend's daughter one time, this past little ice storm that we had.
Ended
up in the ditch. And I was out there penguin walking on the street just to get her out of there and using my off-road tackle box rope. Recovery rope. Kinetic rope.
And last night wasn't the first example of butchering the name. Last night was the most recent example.
Okay.
Because people just cannot process. When you say off-road tackle box, people are asking what kind of fishing gear. And I'm like, no. Off-road is not fishing.
You could go off-road and to-go fishing, but
so,
you could, you can combine the two, but they're not the same thing.
And that's why I said, Corey.
And then go trawling.
Corey, you're in. They're going to continuously try to figure it out and process it and you're in.
But that's okay. That's good. That makes people talk.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Well, you know, but when you're talking about using like the gear and the ropes and so forth for, you know, whether it's for off-roading or other purposes, you know, when people get into off-roading or any hobby, they soon discover that, you know, all these products are not made the same.
Right.
And there are really good ones you can rely on, and there are ones you cannot.
Yes.
And so tell me a little bit about that.
So, I mean, a lot of when you get into the off-road world, that one of our rope is the kinetic rope, and it's not a strap. So with that, it draws energy. And when you're out there, we actually, another perfect example was yesterday. We ended up leaving the ball field and went and saw my girlfriend's grandson had his first T-ball game. Mm-hmm. And so we went out, and sure enough, one of the kids got his F-150 stuck in the mud. We walked up, we walked up to a guy in chains, and he was just boom, just pulling on this thing, trying to get his truck out. And I said, whoa, stopped everybody real quick. I'm like, stop, get that chain off of there. And he could not get him out. Pulled my rope out, put it on, and I'll be dang if it didn't just pull him right out.
I mean,
just like butter. It was
because of that kinetic quality.
And that's exactly what it was. The gentleman got out. He says, I can't believe. He says, I watched that thing stretch, and as it stretched, it just pulled him right out. I says, that's the kinetic energy. That's the draw.
Interesting.
And that's what did it. It was amazing to watch a chain literally smacking that bumper as he's pulling to throwing that kinetic rope on and just slowly winching him right out.
And as the rope is stretching, it allows the person pulling the other one out, it allows the front vehicle to get a little more traction prior to the kinetic energy coming.
Because it's a slower draw. You're getting a slower draw instead of that quick pull. And that does a lot of damage at the same time, you know, whether or not it's going to...
Oh, sure.
You know, pull a bumper off, whatever it may be. I mean, it can get very dangerous. We ended up watching one of the it was a winch rope. Ended up getting a winch rope broke off, went right through the guy's windshield.
Wow.
If he didn't have his head sticking out the window looking where he was going, that would have went right through his head.
Yeah.
And it's stuff like that and doing it safe, you know, whether or not having a cover over top of your ropes and all that stuff. That's the one thing is we try to put into people's heads is safety.
So when you guys decided to start the store, I assume you spent a lot of time going, okay, what products do we want to offer and from where?
Absolutely.
You know.
And we're keeping everything as much U.S. made as we possibly can. Obviously, we want to keep everything U.S. made.
Right.
Unfortunately, it doesn't work that way as much as we wish.
Sure.
But we're doing it as much as possible. And right now, we are in the Jeep world with headlights, taillights, front bumpers, rear bumpers, suspensions, the whole nine yards. If you think it up, if you want to do it, we can do it.
Yeah.
So that's the one nice thing about Off-Road Tackle Box.
Yeah.
We specialize in Jeeps, but it's not just Jeeps. Obviously, you see my truck sitting up there.
Yep.
So trucks, SUVs, anything off-road.
Yep. Underglow. We are branding our own rock lighting now. 3,600 lunettes is what these bad boys are. So they are super, super bright.
Yeah.
From making your nice little mall crawler to being out on
in the woods to flipping your lights on so you can actually see where you're at night.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Well, we have another partner too, Mike Allward. Mike mm-hmm. Allward is he's our mechanic slash partner, business partner, and you know Mike just couldn't handle having his pretty face on the radio.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It's not for all of us. Only certain selected people like
right,
us.
Right. Right. You get it.
Face for the radio.
Right.
Yeah, for sure. But it's kind of interesting that, you know, there are so many people into off-roading around the region. Let's mm-hmm. not just say Erie, but certainly around the region. But what always interests me is you have the guys who go whole hog, mm-hmm. and you have the guys who just sort of moderately go, okay, I want a couple things on my Jeep. I want, you know, the mm-hmm. lights, I want a little bit. And absolutely. Then you have the guys who are like rolling Christmas trees, mm-hmm. you know?
Yeah, that, my dad said it the best one day. He said, if we all lived in blue houses and drove red cars, it would be a boring world.
Yeah.
And it's true. And in the Jeep world, that's what I love about the Jeep world and the Jeep community is everybody's different. Everybody has their own personality, and you can see that personality in their vehicle. Whether mm-hmm. or not it's a basic personality and they just like their Jeep basic, or you want to get stupid crazy and you want to put 40s on it and lockers and the whole nine yards and get out there and just beat the crap out of it. Have at it. Those yeah. people are out there too, and we love all kinds. And that's the love of the Jeep world. That's like yeah. that's like asking to name your Jeep. Name my Jeep for me. Well, I can't name your Jeep for you.
Absolutely.
I don't know what you know. A Jeep is it's a part of you. What have you been through in your life that's made you get to that Jeep?
Oh yeah.
And that's the one love about it is it's all one big community too.
Yeah. My late father, who was a you know he was a Marine and mm-hmm. you know he was in Korea and all this jazz and. He always drove like little pickups my whole life, little pickup, little Chevy Scottsdale, little S10, pickup. And then when he, you know, retired, first thing he did was buy a Jeep. Mm-hmm. First thing he did, you know, because he had that bug, and these guys have that.
Yeah.
Yep. You know? So I fell in love with the Jeep Wrangler. Somebody can probably correct me on this. I want to say maybe either 78 or 1982 when Friday the 13th, part one, came out.
Okay.
And Jason Voorhees' mom was driving a Jeep Wrangler.
And you're like, what is that thing?
I want I love it. And I'm a huge Friday the 13th fan, hence the commercial.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, oh, this is awesome. Yeah. I don't have a Jeep now. I used to. But we didn't. We opened Off-Road Tackle Box just to make a living. There's more of a demand than people realize. And we did it to make yep. a living. We didn't do it essentially to compete with the other
right.
companies around town.
Mm-hmm. Right.
We don't have any enemies. We have nothing no. against them. It's absolutely just not. It's another option, another avenue.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Right. And competition's good.
Competition is
a very good thing. And that's what mm-hmm. I love. And again, it's going into the, I'm not here to make enemies. I'm not here to make frenemies. You know, right. I am here to make a living. And bring the Jeep community together a little bit. And not only that, I personally, in building my Jeep, took me a while to find the right product, to find the right, whether or not it's as simple as the badge logo that goes on your vehicle, mm-hmm. your 4x4 rated badge, to finding a nice metal one that is designed well, that, again, represents you and your vehicle, then buying a plastic one. And then I get it in the mail and go, oh, man, I just right. spent $20 on this yep. piece of plastic.
Yep.
And now you can come to Off-Road Tackle Box and you can get yourself a nice 4x4 badge that's a metal badge that it won't rust. And it's awesome. It's gorgeous. And mm-hmm. it's $20. And you can pick it up. You can feel it. You can touch
yes.
it. And that's the biggest thing is in the Jeep world, picking it up, feeling it, touching it. My dad called it one thing. I can't say what it used to be back in the day, but they like to pick it up. They like to touch it with their sure. fingers. They want to feel it.
Well,
and
yeah.
that's it. You want to feel the quality. You
sure.
want to know. You trust it.
And that's one thing, too, is that, you know, in any endeavor, any hobby, you're always going to have newcomers. You're always going to mm-hmm. have people going, I don't know. Do I really, you know, where they can come to you guys and go, do I really want this? Or right. how does this work? What is mm-hmm. this? What's the function of this? Or yep. is this going to be too much? Or you can't do that when you order online. And like you said, you might get the product and go, this is not what I thought it was.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And that's exactly it. And that's what we're trying to avoid. And I'm trying to help you avoid that because mm-hmm. I've gone through it. So I don't want to watch everybody else go through it. And so now they have a nice home to come to. And if they just want a friendly face to say hi and say, hey, I just bought a Jeep and what can I do to it?
Yeah.
Let's show you. Let me show you what you can do to it. You know, this is how much fun you can have in a Jeep.
Yeah, and that personalization is a huge thing, you know. And mm-hmm. it is interesting how even with just, say, your basic Wrangler, you see people who have it so tricked out. And oh, then yeah. you see the guy who's got, like, you know, the just the most elegant stainless steel shift knob, you know. It's like, you know, like he's treating it like it's a Mercedes, but right? That's cool. That's what you want to do.
Yep,
you
that's
do
exactly
it.
There's your mall crawler. That's your yes. definition of your mall crawler.
That's right.
You just
and
you know,
that's valid.
And that's exactly it. Again, that's your personality. That's the person you are. So be it. You know.
And
you might like an angry girl. I'm not a fan of an angry girl.
Yeah.
But you like it.
Right.
Awesome. I'm not going to judge you for it.
Absolutely.
You know.
And it's not about the competition. It's not about making more competition. It's about personality, personalizing, creativity,
sure.
just other options. They're Sam Catania painting, as you know it, recently we had another painting contractor on here.
Yep.
And we were promoting his name and his phone number and everything. And people were asking me, why would you do that? I said, because it's brilliant.
Yeah.
There's a lot of money to be made in Erie.
Yeah.
A lot of business, a lot of demand, a lot of money. And we're going to have another painting contractor on. I believe it's June 8th I booked him. So we're booking into June already.
Very cool.
Yeah, it's there's you don't have to go into this as, you know, an enemy, a competition. There's a lot of work out there, and there's a lot of demand for what we're doing at Off-Road Tackle Box.
Yeah. Well, yeah, and what usually comes through, and again, this doesn't have to be based in competition, but when you have a passion for something, when you like people, you know, that's usually makes the difference, all other things being equal, you know, and you know, you guys are into it. And it's not just a case of, well, they hired me to stand here behind the counter. I know a little bit about this stuff, so hopefully I'll hook you up with the right thing. It's not that way at all.
No. And it's a passion. That's the one thing I love about it.
Yeah.
We are at 3407 Peach Street, the formerly known Gary Kay's. We're across from the UPMC Imaging Center.
Right. Yep. Everybody knows the former Gary Kay's, for
correct.
Sure.
And the sign still says Gary Kay's. We're working on a sign. We've been working on a sign for months.
Well, that's business. You know,
it takes
a while.
It's not like, hey, we don't need a sign. We've been working on this sign for months.
Yeah. Well, Gary Kay's been established since, what, 1852, I believe.
Something like that.
That sign has been there for so long.
Started off with horses and moved into cars.
Right.
That's why there were so many bays. They actually backed the buggies
right.
in first. The horses stuck out.
So, yeah, we're still trying. We just opened. Things are progressing. It's We're still working on a sign. So in the meantime, we got a flag out front.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know what? We've only got about 5 minutes left. Give me a couple more. I know.
Come on,
I know. It's the way the show goes. Give me a couple more highlights of products you have and what you feature and what you're proud to provide to people.
So basically, right now, the headlights. The headlights are huge. Our headlights are going to be with the halos. So when you're driving and you have your running lights on, your halos are going to be out there. They
Very
also
cool.
are multifunctional RGB to where they can be different colors. But the biggest feature with them is the brightness and
right.
keeping you safe at night. My partner, Mike, he ended up changing from his halogen bulbs into these beautiful LED headlights. And what a difference. He was astounded at how nice they really were.
Yeah.
He lives in Waterford. So once he got out into the country roads, all of a sudden opened up and he could see the deers that he couldn't see before. And he was like, my God.
Yeah.
So,
I know
yeah.
it well.
So, basically, from the headlights down to suspension, you want lifts, tires, wheels, really anything and everything, we can get it. Best Hop, one of our products that we just welcomed into Off-Road Tackle Box. Best Hop, I love Best Hop to death. Also, one of the new products, Clix wipers, just as simple again, something safe, but Clix wipers, they are actually a directional wiper that you have to put on properly. A wiper that you put on properly. You never think you'd say that in a million years,
yeah.
but there is a right and a wrong way to put these on. Once you get them on, you never have to take out the knuckle of it again. It just snaps right in
right.
and when you buy new ones. Clix wipers, love them to death. You can also find them at Off-Road Tackle Box. So a bunch of different products, all kinds. And there's almost too many to mention. You just got to come in and check them out.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's the fun, right? And if you're an off-roader, that's the whole fun is
yep.
going in and checking stuff out. And if people want like a certain item that maybe you don't have in stock, they can order it.
You
can certainly
yep.
guide them to the right one.
Yep, absolutely.
You know, the appropriate one, because that's, again, ordering online, hey, it's convenient, but you can really get stuck very easily.
Oh, absolutely.
Especially
get online.
Any kind of auto parts, you're in trouble.
Yep. And that's exactly it. You get online, and all of a sudden, you think you're ordering for 1 year, and you're getting another year, or yes, whatever it may be. It's don't worry about those headaches. We'll take care of those headaches. If for some odd reason something comes in wrong, we'll take care of it. Mm-hmm. We'll get you the right part. And that was one of the other biggest things, is getting the right stuff in order. And it's tough to get it right now with product and everything. It might take a couple extra days, maybe an extra week. But in the meantime, and we're pretty good about getting stuff in, though.
Yeah,
it's pretty good.
Yeah, very cool. Very
if you're having trouble
you
finding
just needed
it.
One more thing to do, right, Sam? That's what you decided to do.
I love it.
Not busy.
I love it. So if you're having trouble finding it, like I said, we're working on our sign, but you'll see in the meantime, you'll see my big blue monster sitting up there. Mm-hmm. It's at Real Audio right now. Shout out to Real Audio. But once it comes back, you'll see it there all summer.
Green team. Power green team.
Yeah. Yes, there it is.
All
Power
right.
Green
there
team.
It is.
All right. And by the way, what are the hours? Let me ask you that.
Hours are from 9 a.m. to 5 Monday through Friday. And on Saturdays, we are open at 9 a.m. until 2, sometimes 3 o'clock. And if you want something, or just give me a call, give me a text. Yeah. I'll be more than happy to help you guys out. Even just throw out my cell online, throw my cell out there, 814-504-8515. And that's how you can reach me personally.
Corey's new at this. Yeah.
Just remember.
It's like I never had a mic in my face.
Corey's new at this.
Just remember, it's not off-road shoebox. Just know that. It's off-road tackle box.
Off-road tackle box.
All right.
And next week, we're back on Wednesday. 9 a.m. Following Wednesday, 9 a.m., Catania Chronicles. Catania Chronicles. Next week's special guest is Mark Prillo of the Erie Seawolves.
All right. My buddy Mark. Very cool. Very cool. Thank you, gentlemen.